Now, this anatomy holds true for all of our ruminant farm species, so that's your cattle, sheep, goats, but also for pigs. They've also got the two toes there. But of course, with all these species, there are certainly species differences, which I find really interesting. So cattle, for example, have really rigid toes, very hard hooves. They've evolved to migrate long distances on the flat ground. Compare that with a goat, who's quite the other end of the spectrum, has evolved to thrive in mountainous terrain, on rocks. So anyone who has goats knows that they are fantastic climbers with great balance, and that comes down to their hooves. Their toes are shaped a little differently. If you pick their feet up, the toe looks more like a pear shape. And the toes are more flexible as well, so they can literally climb and balance on an almost vertical rock face. Very different to a cow. Now, because they're made for rocks, their hoof wall also grows a lot faster than cattle or sheep, because it's expecting to naturally be worn down all the time by that abrasive rocky surface. Pigs are completely different again. They want to live on the damp undergrowth of a forest floor, so their little hooves aren't wearing down very quickly at all. They actually grow quite slowly. Pig toes are also very flexible, so that they can shift their weight easily running over the undulating ground of a forest floor instead of constantly spraining their ankles. And finally, our camelids need a special mention. Llama and alpaca, these guys don't have hooves as such, but they are still two-toed. Instead, they have a thick leathery foot pad on the bottom of the foot that they walk on, and then toenails. So they look quite interesting. These toenails do still need trimming. They do still suffer from some of our common diseases though that we'll run through in a minute. So these guys, camelids, alpaca and llama, they come from the same family as camels, hence the name, who have massive wide fat pads on their feet to stop them from sinking into sand. Pretty cool, right? These littlest members of the camel family, the alpaca and llama, have been domesticated in South America. So they don't need those giant white fat pads anymore to have them set up for the Saharan desert. So theirs have sunken down, but they still do have those leathery fat pads. Now, if you're farming one of these species, what you're going to notice as well is that there are most definitely interspecies differences. So different breeds of sheep and goats that have been domesticated in different countries, different climates, they have different hoof qualities and may be known for having good or bad feet, especially for a certain climate like New Zealand. A lot of hoof quality comes down to genetic predispositions as well, especially things like conformation of those toes. So always a really good idea to try and not breed from individuals that have a lot of foot problems. Favor those hardy genes and those healthy feet.